Back behind the play, Nick Letty shaking up. Here comes Alan Quine, nice move. And then a shot stopped by Malaga, rebound, score, Ryan Strome. 5-3 Islanders.
The Islanders were livid. They thought Barkov hit Letty from behind in this situation. It's close, but it leads to the Islanders on a quick counterattack. Now they're up the ice. Florida's going for a change, and it's a bit of a sloppy change. The Islanders have numbers going to the net, and look at that dead spot coverage for Ryan Strome. Good job by Quine, doing a little whoop-de-doo, puts it on Roberto Luongo, chunky rebound. Ryan Strome jumps on it, and he gives the Islanders a two-goal cushion.
Boychuk will send this one in. Played right back up the middle and sent home. And it's 1-0 Islanders.
Boychuk throws it in deep. Louis Domingue comes out to play the puck. Louis Domingue turns it over.
Wide.
Throws a pepperoni pizza right up the middle of the ice to nobody.
And in front, Quine couldn't get a shot away. Giordano throws a pass across. They score! Alan Quine set up by Mark Giordano.
He keeps the puck alive. And then Ryan, they shuffle it around. Giordano, instead of shooting, he spots Quine.
Hickey back, Jedlicki across, and a score! Alan Quine with his first Stanley Cup playoff goal, and it's an overtime winner for the Islanders. A power play goal, and Alan Quine has ended the marathon at the 16-minute mark of double overtime.
Really good composure by the New York Islanders. They gain the zone. One chance by Luongo off the shot block. Big one by Jussi Jokinen. They keep it alive. Josh Bailey moves it out. Aaron Zedlicki with some composure. Keep moving it around. Now Zedlicki going to pump it, and then Quine right in. You love the composure factor, moving a D to D. That little pump fake opens it up for Quine, and he just beats Luongo short side.
19 in Bridgeport this year, a late call-up, and now an overtime hero. And the Islanders take the series lead, 3-2, and a pair of overtime wins.
Certainly okay for the backup.
Yeah, and that's just in the month of January as the shot goes in. Alan Quine, tie game.
Not sure if the original shot went in or not. On the hard, long wrist shot, Alan Quine didn't wait to make sure. He sees the opportunity, and the Islanders get a power play goal. But again, another faceoff win for the Islanders on the power play. And then the quick release shot that gets it on net. Excuse me, that's Ladd that lets that shot go. And it's Quine down low, and he makes no mistake about it.
Back for Hanifin, and he works in. And off the arm of Allen, rebound, they score! Quine, and it's 4-0.
And the shot by Hanifin, good save right there with the left arm. And then the rebound as Quine gets inside the defenseman, Robert Bortuzzo, and knocks it home.
And kept in by Brody. And now Zarnik to the net. Quine, he scores! Binnington got bumped, maybe by his own man, Butler, and a wide open net. And it's 7-2.
There's the jam play right there. And you see Butler's trying to hold the fort right there, and he gets knocked down. And that's why the youngster Kirby Reichel right there goes to the front of the net. And it's just a simple case of Butler losing his balance there. And
Brody taps that into the corner, waiting for it to deco. Getting on him is Austin Zarnik. Poked up ahead to Gaudreau, turned over to Anderson.
Side to go to the backhand and put it up over top of Saros. Just a terrific play by him to finish this one off.
Just a guess on my part.
Seidenberg's blast. It's wrapped up with Mason. They score! Shane Prince in his 100th NHL game pops it over Mason and gives the Islanders a 2-0 lead.
And then it's Quine who gets it past Mason. Mason can't control the rebound. Prince was a distraction, so Mason couldn't follow it all the way, couldn't track it.
Islanders still with the man advantage. Back to Boychuk. He steers it across ice. Boychuk again takes his shot in front of the net, knocked down, the rebound right in front again, and then they're whack at it. Came in front, another shot, they score! Tipped into the net by Alan Quine, and the Islanders with the power play goal have taken the lead.
Now that's only the Islanders' 11th power play goal on the season. And Quine's gonna get this goal, and he's gonna put his team up by one here. And it's just some scrambling.
Off the faceoff, able to send it down there. Allmark out to play it, lost the puck. He's coming out to play it himself. Now an open net in front. Cairns gets it in front. They score. Quinney goes to the front of the net for the shorthanded goal, and we are tied at two.
And Linus Allmark's going to get caught out of the net right here. He comes out a little too slow, not able to get back in time. You're going to see the pass thrown to the front. And Quinney doesn't get his stick on it, it bounces off the thigh, his right thigh.
And it bounced into his skates as he was looking the opposite direction, and he'll lead a 3-on-2 with Quine. Quine walks in and scores! Alan Quine, and it's 4-2 Islanders.
Now watch the poise on this youngster. Stays wide, waits, drops it, and then Quine makes a nice inside move and just drives it in. Quine had the opportunity at the time because everybody back, everybody up. But look at it, he just looks, throws it back, and then drives towards the net, takes some sacrifice.